X about me. I'm a hustler, homie.
Welcome back to another episode of Drag to America. I'm your host, Ty Worldwide, and it's February, so you know everybody's talking about Black history. I'm recognizing an American hero you hardly hear about. I'll be discussing a Black hero that most definitely needs a biopic. I hope to create this successful biopic through God's grace. This guy needs more recognition, in my opinion. Robert Smalls was tired of hateful Democrats tormenting his life. He was tired of fighting the enemy. All of his weaknesses went straight out the window to plan his historical escape from slavery. Let's get straight to it. The burning bush for freedom burned inside the soul of a determined 23-year-old slave named Robert Smalls. This skilled enslaved warrior had a will to remove his family and himself from oppression. Smalls had a yearning for real humanity. Freedom played the minds of Smalls for years. Smalls had a fear of his family being separated due to wicked slave masters selling enslaved blacks for profit. All impoverished slaves dealt with anxieties of being split up, sold like a pack of gum on the auction block. Enslaved blacks were most likely to be separated a few times in their life, unless they seek a plan to escape. Newspapers would actually place classified ads promoting human beings for sale. Evil slave masters usually separated families. Smalls had a desire to change his whole narrative. Stagnation was not in this man's vocabulary at all. Blackness was the scenery in the city of Charleston, South Carolina on May 13, 1862. This is when this courageous enslaved black man executed a plan to seize his power and respect. Winds made the ship's bell sound, and the noises of the ocean waters filled the air. The plan he created was to take over a kind steamboat named the Planter. Once the three white captains left the boat near Fort Sumter, he planned his big escape well after the Civil War began. The first round of issues in the plan was the three whites who managed the Planter. Smalls and his crew would need to have things in order to take over the boat. Once the three Caucasians left the boat to explore the shore, Smalls made his move to get away. After Smalls secured the Planter, the next trouble on Smalls' mind was to avoid other Confederate soldiers throughout the travels up the coast. The pursuit to rescue his family was another concern. Smalls' family members were hiding out in a steamer boat up the Cooper River waiting to be picked up by Smalls. This is what you call a united front. Smalls' wife, children, and others hiding out had complete faith in the process. Unfortunately, it was not an easy task. However, Smalls rescued his family and others. The Confederate checkpoint Smalls had to surpass were the most terrifying moments of the voyage. If he was caught crossing, everyone on board would surely be killed by the Confederate army. The night of this heroic plan, there was a thick, dark fog. Smalls was pleased with this detail. The fog made the Confederate flags not visible on the cotton steamer. As he sailed up the coast, there was a Union ship approaching. Smalls didn't want the Union to attack his boat. Robert Smalls was so brilliant, he had his white captain's clothing and hat on, as well as a cloth-like white flag. Smalls had his crew replace the Confederate flag with the white flag. His crew hoisted the white flag up high in the sky like a kite, so the Union would be able to see it. The Planter finally made it to a Union port. As the crew controlled the vessel, the excitement was building. In celebration, Smalls along with many on board started jumping, dancing, and screaming, while the rest were angered and disgusted by Fort Sumter. The events the slaves endured was brutal. After the anger left, the freedom set in. All 16 slaves, men, women, and children on board were free for the first time in their lives. When the Union generals and others seen the poise and courage Smalls had to pull this off, he was recognized with top honors. Fantastic Smalls was a Renaissance man. He served triumphantly in the Union Navy. This heroic, courageous man was the first black captain in the Navy. During the Civil War, Smalls sustained an attack and was injured on Fort Sumter. After the war, he was still prosperous. During the Reconstruction era, he took on the superb leadership role. Robert Smalls was heavily involved in politics. He was elected as a Republican congressman. Smalls and blacks was appreciative and grateful for the Republican Party. On August 22, 1912, Robert Smalls wrote a letter to U.S. Senator Nelson saying, "I never lose sight of the fact that, had it not been for the Republican Party, I never would have been an officer holder of any kind." Smalls loved the Republican Party. He referred to the Republican Party as the party that unshackled the necks of millions of human beings. Republicans elected him to 5 terms in Congress. Smalls wanted to bury the racist Democratic Party. This letter to the Republicans shows Smalls' solidarity to the party. Smalls was elected to South Carolina House of Representatives in 1868. He also became a member of an unexpired term in the Senate. Robert Smalls was an eloquent speaker and wise debater. This man became a publisher of a newspaper. This freed black man served as a custom collector in Beaufort, South Carolina. His name gains respect throughout the Republican Party. Robert Smalls was such a hustler for freedom, he actually purchased his master's house for his family. That's a boss move for real. That's something I think is dope, how Robert Smalls was a hustler for his own destiny. He took a whole ship to sail the seas of freedom. He made something happen. He went from the slave house to buying his master's house. He was one of the first black captains in the Navy. He was a strong black leader in the Republican Party. I learned excellent strong black leaders from the Reconstruction era helped lead the Republican Party with other Republican white abolitionists. Actually, our black freed men and women praised the Republican Party. Robert Smalls and other free blacks despised the Democratic Party. I asked the question, when did the parties change positions? Robert Smalls was a misfit that was outside of the box. While all the abusive tactics and distractions enslaved blacks were dealt, it's great to know he focused on the things that were important, leaving all the hellacious distractions behind. Smalls seized the opportunity. I personally think it's horrific to know other humans own other humans as property. My hat goes off to Smalls for taking an initiative to get away. Now, imagine if thousands of slaves joined forces with Smalls. I know blacks would have had a different outcome today. Smalls' sheer determination was a motivating factor that changed his life. His mentality was get free or die trying. Did some enslaved blacks see a need to have an identity of their own? I noticed Robert Smalls had faith. He put his life on the line. He didn't limit God and did the work. I mean, think of it. What if most enslaved blacks knew the possibility of freedom? There would be a whole different narrative in history. Robert Smalls was a visionary. He'd seen his worth. I feel it sad how many slaves were loyal to pleasing a master that didn't treat them worth a nickel. These oppressors never had good intentions for African slaves. The devilish slave master would inflict many forms of cruelty on slaves. The heinous evil treatment overshadowed the slaves' lives until the torture became a normal way of life for enslaved blacks. Our ancestors gave their life and made it their duty to serve these democratic white supremacists. I know someone may say, that's all enslaved blacks knew. It's not their fault for being enslaved. I agree, and it hurts to know those white, roughneck racists brutalized our ancestors throughout history. African slaves helped build this country on their backs for free. We are all tremendously appreciative. We all are thankful for the Robert Smalls and the Harriet Tubmans of slavery that took charge escaping. This proves our black trailblazers were mighty forces that didn't care what their oppressors thought of them. They pursued freedom no matter what obstacles were in front of them. These freed blacks recognized they were worthy of freedom. The majority of slaves didn't recognize they were worthy of anything. Today, several folks in the black community are still obligated to systems and trends that don't care about their well-being. This seems to be the same mentality numerous slaves had. It's a stagnant spirit that takes over a few black minds. It's like their mind tells them, oh well, this is all I can get. I'm okay right here at the bottom of the totem pole with nothing. There are a few that are satisfied with just enough to pay bills and eat ramen noodles all day. I'm researching, learning, and listening to gain more knowledge about these touchy topics. Nonetheless, I witness a range of blacks with these behaviors. I know times are rough for many. But I know for sure it takes a certain type of person to hustle and hit the pavement every day to make a way out of poverty. Hustlers are determined go-getters. There are somewhat different hustles, but I can't knock the next man's hustle. You know, I'm not a judge. Nonetheless, I know for sure no matter what hood, you should want way more than sad mediocrity nothingness. You must move and pursue through God to make something happen. My people always know faith without work is dead. The leaders back in the day hustled and put the work in. They hit the ground running for freedom and justice. Whether blacks used the Underground Railroad or marched in the streets, they pursued and sacrificed for us to have liberty today. It seems like some blacks compete with other blacks instead of working together. To me, it makes no sense to compete with anyone because you don't know what the next man's shoes are filled with. You never know what a person had to go through to gain what they have. I wonder, is Willie Lynch syndrome the ultimate destroyer causing the black-on-black hate? Self-hatred in the community is a big deal. I wonder if someone feels equal to the next man, is there a need to compete? Competition is for what? Why aren't some blacks happy for the next one? I hope the black communities can start uplifting one another. Have faith and trust in God. This is the only remedy. Blacks are resilient. We can overcome these burdens. I know all the trials I've been through has not been easy. One thing I know though, I had to encourage myself, build myself up somehow and keep going. I thank God for that. I give God the glory for making a way for my family to pursue. Where would blacks be today if we didn't have these black warriors that led the charge for change? I'm glad our heroes didn't sit back and wait for masses to let our people go. Robert Smalls chose to look at the glass half full rather than half empty. I know our ancestors' sacrifice was humiliated, punished, yet they kept going. Robert Smalls, I salute you for real. Thank you, sir, for protecting your family, being the head and not the tail. Drag to America will always tackle Black history today, not just in this month of February. Tune in for the next episode of Drag to America, where I'll be tackling another topic to bring awareness to issues in our communities. My mother tells me daily, if people are serious about certain causes within the community, they should stop donating to them and start investing in them instead. Makes sense to me. Be sure to like and subscribe. Don't forget to wash your hands a million times, spray lights on your house, car, and in the elevators. I'm Tyrell Wide. Take care. God bless.
Do that dance, if you a hustler, then do that dance. Yeah, let's go. Do that dance, do that dance. If you a hustler, then do that dance.